We've been told that Apple's most powerful Mac, the Mac Pro, is going to be getting a spring launch with the brand new M2 Ultra chipset. I want to share the latest on this with the latest roundup of everything we know so far, including specs and, of course, the Apple Mac Pro 2023 release date and price. So, back in 2019, we had the brand new Mac Pro come out with the latest Intel Xeon chips inside. The Mac Pro is considered as the god desktop for creators and developers. It is one of four desktop computers in the current Macintosh lineup, sitting up above the consumer Mac Mini, iMac, and the Mac Studio models. It is also Apple's most powerful Mac that they make. The new design went back to a tower design after it came from that similar design for the second generation. The new design includes a new thermal architecture with three impeller fans that promises to prevent the computer from having to throttle the processor so it can always run at peak performance levels. But let's press on when it's likely we're going to get our hands on the new Mac Pro. The Mac Pro is due a refresh as it's the last Intel Mac out there right now, and it definitely needs an Apple Silicon refresh, as the last time we also had an update to the Mac Pro was in late 2019. Apart from the 2013 Mac Pro, the models before from 2006 to 2012 had upgrades around every 18 months to 2 years with newer Intel chipsets put inside. So we've had a report in from Mark Gurman telling us that the Mac Pro is likely to be coming at a spring event, what I'd like to talk about a little bit more in a moment. But the other news is that the Mac Pro will be getting an M2 Ultra inside, what is essentially two M2 Maxes stitched together. Based on numbers from the M2 Max, this would mean we could be getting up to 24 cores in CPUs and up to 76 cores for the GPU, what would be absolutely amazing. Then for RAM, this could mean we could be getting up to 192GB of RAM as an option too. However, for release date, it is likely that Apple will stay on the tradition of launching the Mac Pro. For every single Mac Pro since 2006, with the first generation design borrowed from the G5 with the Intel chipsets, to the trash can design in 2013, and also the current cheese grater design in 2019, every single one of these Macs have been announced before the summer, either in March or April, or they've come later on at a WWDC event. With this, we've been told by Mark Gurman that the Mac Pro is coming in the first half of 2023, which means that it's likely that a spring event or either the latest WWDC 2023 is when we'll be getting our hands on the brand new Mac Pro. And either case you look at this, it will be launching very soon. So then guys, just quickly, I want to say a massive thank you from the bottom of my heart. This YouTube channel has just got over 500,000 subscribers, or 500,000 subscribers. And it's all thanks to you guys. Thank you so much for your support. I really, really do appreciate it from the bottom of my heart. And for that, as you probably already know, I am doing a giveaway on this channel, and that's going to be for three prizes. We have the M1 Pro MacBook Pro 14-inch. We also have the M2 MacBook Air, and we also have that iPhone 14 Pro Max 2. And I'll be announcing who the winner is this upcoming Monday or Tuesday. So, with the latest reports and release date out of the way, let's move on to a summary of everything we know so far that previous leaks have painted a picture of the details for the new Mac Pro with its price as well. So, what we've been told so far for the brand new Mac Pro is that it will be the same design. So, this is the 2019 Mac Pro design, or known as the cheese grater design. It will feature an M2 Ultra chipset inside it, will have up to 24 CPU cores. And basically, this will be made up of 8 efficiency cores and also 16 performance cores. What the M2 Ultra essentially is two M2 Maxes stitched together to give that ultra performance. We've also been told that for the GPU performance, where this Mac Pro will really shine, is there will be a choice between 60 to 72 cores of GPU cores, was absolutely amazing. Then on top of that as well, there'll also be 4 times videos, decoders and encoders for all you video editors out there. And then for the RAM, you'll have the choice of 64 to 192 gigabytes of RAM. We've also been told that the storage most likely this time in the Mac Pro and the first of any of the Apple Silicon devices will be upgradable. So this basically means essentially that you'll be able to stick in your own hard drives. We're not too sure at this stage if they're going to be Apple exclusive hard drives or you'll be able to just buy any kind of hard drives and just put them inside the Mac Pro. We're not too sure at this stage. But something else that we've also been told is that Apple are going to find a way to make it that you can also put in slot cards to be upgradable too. So this could basically means you could put in sound cards and also you might be able to put in some graphics cards as well on top of the standard M2 Ultra GPU that we have right now. The starting price of this new Mac Pro will start in at $5,999 US, and this will be the basic configuration Mac Pro. So this will be having an M2 Ultra, and this will mean it will have a 60-core GPU, and it will have 64 gigabytes of RAM inside it for this option. So that is a summary of the new Mac Pro. And like I said, if we get any more information of what the Mac Pro will be having inside it, I will be updating this report and letting you guys know in a future video. So if you haven't done so already, make sure you subscribe to this channel and hit that notification bell to make sure to get those updates. However, for my thoughts and wishes, my wish is to do with the actual Mac Pro and basically something I just talked about in the actual report here. And that's what makes the Mac Pro so great. And that is the ability to upgrade bits and pieces inside. Now, with Apple Silicon being an all-in-one chip for CPU, GPU and RAM altogether, I feel like that no changes of these three components are normally going to be probably upgradable. So the Mac Pro might have to stick with this and you'll be stuck with that chipset forever. However, I really do hope that Apple do some sort of magic here, that you can do some upgrades in some sort of shape or form. So you could upgrade the storage and maybe put an expansion card, so maybe get a different sort of graphics card inside, sound card or video recording cards. You get the idea, some sort of abilities like that, because that would be really, really awesome. I really do hope that Apple do not take away from the Mac Pro this ability, because it'd be so disappointing. And essentially, you may as well just get yourself, say, a Mac Studio instead. But if they did do that, to put that ability to upgrade the parts, that would be awesome. But those are my thoughts, and I'd love to know if you feel the same about this. And with that, guys, it's also time to wrap up this video. So if you have enjoyed watching it, please make sure to like the video. And also, if you want to hear the latest Apple news, reviews, and comparisons, make sure you subscribe to this channel and hit that notification bell. Until next time, guys, I will see you really soon. Bye-bye.